We changed our location from that emergency Red Cross shelter that was up on Washington Street. We're there all morning long. We wanted to bring you down to this residential area. We're on Foster Street, and this is one of those low-lying, flood-prone areas that we've been talking about all morning long. But you can see here, they have a pretty good lake going. But I talked to firefighters. They say, really? This is mild compared to what they dealt with in 2005. I want to show you some video of the firefighters coming down this street earlier today, rolling through the neighborhood where many Keene State students rent houses to check on residents and recommend voluntary evacuations for the next several hours. Door knocks and friendly chats with residents reminding them that a shelter is open on Washington Street. But veterans of flooding here say so far what they're seeing is minor compared to 6 years ago.
We're going door to door with some pamphlets letting people know that this is where the problems area is in the past, and just letting them know that there is an opportunity to go to the Washington Street at the rec center for, you know, evacuation purposes. It's not a mandatory evacuation right now, but it's a place for them to go or to think about that or start prompting people that this is an area that's problems in the past.
Want to show you some video from Chapman Road we shot just a little while ago. Large tree bringing down power lines there, forcing the closure of part of Chapman Road. Firefighters say at this stage of the game, every wire down should be considered a live wire, and that power companies are telling them customers who lose power should plan on being without it for some time because crews will not be sent up to do repairs in high wind conditions. Also wanted to give you an update on that Red Cross shelter up on Washington Street. Ironically, Washington Street is suffering a power loss at this time as well. I talked to the Red Cross up there. They tell me that they're on generator power so that they are fully equipped to handle the people that want to come in and take shelter out of the storm. Right now, we're told 7 people are hunkering down and waiting out as Irene passes through. That's the latest from Keene. We're live. We'll hand it back to you.